is the 2018 Honda Jazz. And even according to Honda, it's not an all-new car. In fact, it's not even an MMC or a mild model change that you would get halfway through a car's product cycle. What it is an update. And if you're standing from right there, you're going to be struggling to figure out what's new. What is new, however, on the Honda Jazz, visually speaking, is limited, but they're nice additions to make it look more premium and more appealing. For one, the diesel top variants and the petrol automatic top now comes with chrome door handles. And the biggest change, visually speaking, on the Honda Jazz are the new set of LED tail lamps, which now have better congruity between the unit that runs on the pillar and the one that's on the tailpiece itself. There is also a tubular unit that runs through the center that really ups the premium feel and makes it feel like a premium hatchback that it's supposed to be. The Jazz relevant with the competition, the 2018 version comes with a whole lot of little features that make it much better. Starting with the DigiPad 2.0, which is now a 7-inch touchscreen infotainment system with Android Auto, Apple CarPlay, and inbuilt navigation. It also gets a reverse parking camera with grid lines that makes it a lot easier to park in tight spaces in the urban environment. The top spec diesel and the top spec automatic petrol also get the illuminated red start-stop button like you would have in the Honda City. There's now a center armrest with storage, as well as a vanity mirror on the driver's side. Now, in the back seats of the Jazz, it's still a comfortable, spacious hatchback with a lot of headroom and a lot of legroom. Although what goes missing on the 2018 version is the fact that magic seats have been done away with completely, so no more trick folding seats. And another thing that's really missing, as far as we're concerned on this update, is a rear AC vent. Another one of my pet peeves from the back seat of the Honda Jazz is the fact that there are no more adjustable headrests. And even if they wanted to do away with the adjustable headrests, these ones are pretty tiny, and even for someone who's under 6 feet tall, it'll be really difficult to use as a headrest. So now if you have to talk about the engine and performance in the 2018 Honda Jazz, you're not going to find a lot different. The 1.2 litre petrol and the 1.5 litre diesel have both been retained. And that's not so much of a bad thing, although the engines could have used a little more grunt, considering that the 1.2-litre petrol makes about 89 horsepower and the 1.5-litre diesel makes about 99, which is a fair amount of power, although with a chassis this good, the Jazz could use with a little extra grunt. That said, the 1.5-litre Ivy Tech engine from the Honda City would have been a welcome addition to the Honda Jazz's engine portfolio, so to speak. Another welcome addition to the Jazz in 2018 is the addition of cruise control. Now, while this only features on the top automatic petrol and the top diesel variants, it still makes for a very easy drive and it gives your feet a bit of a rest, which is a welcome thing in the urban condition again. Once again, being a Honda, the Jazz is ahead on safety, with ABS and dual airbags being offered as standard across all variants. That aside, you also get a few additional features on the locking system, which include keyless entry and speed sensing door locks. All in all, the Jazz is still a very good car to drive. It's very refined, although we would have appreciated a little bit more in terms of dynamics, as well as maybe the 1.5 litre engine from the Honda City iV. So at the end of it, the 2018 Honda Jazz is still a comfortable, convenient and spacious hatchback that provides an alternative to the likes of the Baleno and the i20s that you would find in this segment. What the update has brought with it is some new features and some new styling cues to make it more relevant to prospective buyers.